night. You got an ice pack I could borrow?
Ethan! Oh, damn it. Looks like you got hit by a truck.
Feels more like 10. Thanks.
What the hell happened? These guys do this to you?
No. There were these high rollers. They wanted high stakes. I wasn't very discerning about their characters, so I opened up the back room at the Star.
I'm not following. You're a smart gambler.
Not this time. I wanted easy cash, so I got in over my head.
So you gambled with money you didn't have. Stupid.
Well, I realized that about the time I was face down on the floor covered in fresh boot prints.
I give you good money to work for me. Why this sudden need for cash?
It's this bet with Edward. You know, Maya and I stay married for a year. We get $1 million. You know, it just seemed like a no-brainer. All we gotta do is stay together and we get a payout.
Okay, so what's going on? You and Maya not getting along?
No, it's the opposite. She's amazing, you know. It's a good deal.
I'm not seeing the problem, Ethan.
I don't trust myself in relationships. All right, a year's gonna go by, it's gonna get better and better, and I'm gonna have to break Maya's heart. You know, she deserves better than that. And I thought if I could get the money, she wouldn't have to go through with the bargain.
Okay, so let me get this straight. You care for Maya deeply, so you're going to give her money to break up with you.
Molly, ready to go?
Oh, good. There you are. Come on. You gotta hustle. We have to get there. We're gonna be late.
Are these shoes okay?
They're fine. Let's go.
I think I'm gonna change.
Honey, the shoes are fine, really. We have a half hour before it starts. We gotta go.
I'll just be a minute.
Molly, no one's going to be looking at your shoes. They're not. They're going to be looking at you, your beautiful face, this girl who's going to be standing in front of the school being honored for her heroism during the bus crash. It's pretty cool.
Why is everyone pushing me?
We're not pushing you, sweetie. We're just looking
for... Well, stop! It's my award. Who cares if I'm 1 minute late? I get to wear the shoes I want.
It's not that big a deal. Are you okay?
I am so sorry I was snappy. I don't feel so good.
You don't, honey? What's wrong? Do you have a headache?
It's mostly kind of an ache all over.
Oh, it's not the flu.
All right, let me see if you have a fever.
No, it's okay. I don't have a fever.
Yeah, but if you ache all over, then...
Well, it's mostly in my stomach. I don't know. Maybe I ate something that didn't agree with me. Can I stay home from school? I'm sure I'll feel better tomorrow.
How about we just go to the ceremony and I'll bring you right home?
No. What if I throw up on stage?
You really feel that bad?
Honey, is it that bad, really, that you're not going to go? Isn't that going to be disappointing?
Yeah, it really is.
You sure? All right, I'll call Viola and see if she can come take care of you. I'm really sorry about this, honey. If anyone deserves to be recognized by the whole school, it's you.
So you dragged me here for this?
Like this? This can hear you.
Ethan got the crap beat out of him by several guys. He lost consciousness at least once. I'd say that qualifies as serious.
If he'd warned me what I was in for, I could have smuggled a portable x-ray.
If I'd warned you, you wouldn't have come.
Ow. Come on.
You're such a baby.
It's damn right I am, especially when you punch something that's broken.
That's not even broken.
As opposed to all the others?
Okay, you know what? There's not much else I can do without the right equipment.
Fine. Get out of here, then. You're a psycho anyway. You'd probably make me worse just for fun.
Okay, I'm done.
I didn't like how you are.
Have you even listened to him? He doesn't even want me to treat him. This is a waste of my time.
You're just bitter because I dragged away from Patrick.
Really?
Hey, don't let the door hit you on the way out.
Hey, both of you, shut up and cooperate, all right? I still got the syringe that you were going to use on Robin, so fix Ethan up or your career's trashed. And you, suck it up. If you refuse help, you end up in the hospital. Maya sees you got beat to a pulp. She's going to want to know why.
All right, Viola's going to be here in a half hour. Christina, can you stay with your sister until then?
No problem.
Thanks. Okay, I'm gonna be in court. So if you need me, you text me, okay?
Okay.
All right, and I know your tummy hurts, but you might want to try eating something. Maybe some toast, a banana, something bland. Okay? And if you get a temperature, it's okay for Viola to give you some medicine, but she needs to call me first.
Mom, I'll be fine. I just need to rest.
Okay. I love you.
Love you.
Okay. I'll call you in an hour.
Okay.
All right. Thank you. I'll see you later. Bye, girls.
Bye.
Bye.
You're not really sick. You're just stuck in the award ceremony.
No, I'm not.
Molly,
you're a really bad liar.
My mom believes me.
That's because Mom thinks you're the most truthful kid on the planet. Plus, it's unimaginable to her that you wouldn't want to accept your award. I don't get it either. You really were a hero. You hiked up to the road with Michael, found a cell phone, called Mom.
You would have done the same thing if you hadn't had hypothermia.
You were truly courageous that night. Why don't you want to be honored for that?
I just don't feel like going to the ceremony.
Why?
I'm not really lying. The truth is my stomach does hurt, and I think it's because I'm afraid of the crowd and the noise and all those people staring at me.
Okay, so you want to put hydrogen peroxide on the wound twice a day, and don't put your greasy fingers all over it.
My insides hurt like hell.
You probably cracked a few ribs, but there's nothing I can do about that. So you should come up with a plausible cover story, because he's going to be black and blue for quite some time.
Do try to contain your grief.
Well, whatever you did to get beaten up, I'm sure it was stupid.
Johnny, can you curb stomp her for me?
All right, I'm leaving.
I'll expect you to check up on Ethan once daily for the remainder of the week.
I'm sorry, so I tend to you, and now you expect me to just wet nurse this idiot? How am I supposed to cover up my job?
You won't have a job if I turn in the syringe.
Fine. So I nurse him back to health. Can you give me the syringe back?
I'll think about it. If anybody finds out you got beat up playing poker, cops will be on it.
You know, I'm more concerned about Maya. Yeah, I mean, I could tell her I took a fall snowboarding.
Hey, you think she'll buy that?
Probably not. She knows I hate the snow.
Hey, back to the drawing board.
You know, I could tell her it was your fault. Deal gone wrong with the Trujillo or something like that.
Wow, or here's a novel concept, and I know it may be far-fetched coming from me, but how about the truth, huh? Why not tell her that you don't want her taking money from Edward, so you thought you'd make some for her?
I don't want Maya to know.
You don't want Maya to know you lost a playing cards, huh?
It would ruin my reputation. Also, it would risk Maya thinking I did a noble deed, all right? I need her to... need to be her idea to break up with me.
Uh-huh. Wow, you know what? This is so messed up. How about I just save you the trouble and tell Maya for you?
No, Johnny, swear you won't tell her.
Oh, overreact much.
Look, I'm serious, Johnny. Look, I don't want to hurt Maya, okay? She's a great girl, and she deserves someone just as great. You know, someone who's gonna fall for her and commit in the whole nine yards.
I think you got the falling part covered.
I wouldn't go that far.
No. Ethan, you've made your feelings for Maya abundantly clear. You think maybe it's time to... I don't know, man up and own him. Tell her, huh?
Johnny! Johnny, are you there?
Time to man up?
No.
Hey, it's me, Maya. Johnny!
Maya, what's up?
I'm really worried about Ethan. I still haven't heard from him, have you?